All right, so we learned in the last section, the last two sections about exponentials. And what makes a function an exponential function? It's because your variable is located up in the exponent. So everything is fine and dandy, so let's just do a couple things. If I've got 2 to the fourth, which is 2 times 2 times 2 times 2, okay, that gives me 16. If I do 2 to the third, which is 2 times 2 times 2, that is 8. If I do 2 squared, that is 4. If I do 2 to the first, that is 2. If I do 2 to the zero power, remember any number to the zero power is 1, it's not 0. Okay, so how did I move from here to here? How did I move from here to here? How did I keep moving? So all I did was divide by 2. Okay, so 16 divided by 2 is 8. Divided by 2 is 4. Divided by 2 is 2. Divided by 2 is 1. Well, if I continue that, then what I have is 2 to the negative 1 equals 1 divided by 2. Okay, so do it again, and that gives me 1 divided by 4. So you can see it's just the flip of what's going on here, or the reciprocal. Okay, so I've got a 2 over 1 here. Well, it's going to be a 1 over a 2 here. I got a 4 over 1, 1 over 4, 8 over 1, 1 over 8. Okay, so what does that mean? Because I'm not always going to write this thing out to follow the pattern. First of all, remember that any number to the zero power is 1. Okay, any number to the first power is just the base. Okay, it just repeats itself. So if this is a 14 to the first, it's 14. Okay, so there's a 1 sitting there. Remember, a negative exponent will tell you to flip its location in the fraction. So for instance, if I put 2 to the negative 1, remember I can write anything over 1. Well, that negative is telling me to do something. And it's saying, please put me in the opposite location in the fraction from where I am right now. So this negative says, well, I'm in the numerator. I actually belong in the denominator. And now that I did what that negative said to do, it goes away. But remember, I'm also too lazy to write a first power. So 2 to the first power is 2. Okay, so do it again. What happens if I have 2 to the negative 2? I can write anything over 1. This negative is going to tell me to put this thing in the opposite location of the fraction. So this negative says I am currently in the numerator. I actually belong in the denominator. Okay? And now you've done what that negative said to do, so it disappears. And then what is 1 over 2 squared? It is 1 over 4. So now we know what negative exponents will tell us to do. So everything is fine and wonderful as long as we're in exponential land. We're not always going to stay in exponential land. So, for example, what if I wanted to raise 2 to some power and I wanted to get an answer of 6.124? Okay, so I know it's going to be in here. How do I know it's in there? Because 6.124 is between 4 and 8. So that means my exponent must be between 2 and 3. So it's going to be a fractional exponent or a decimal exponent. Okay, so that is what logarithms are for. So a logarithm, okay, is a way to figure out what this missing exponent is. Okay, it is a way to figure out what this missing exponent is. So you should have a calculator. You should have a scientific calculator, which has a log button on it. Okay, so now that we know that, we're going to go forward. We're going to just practice back and forth for a few minutes. Now, come back up here for just a second. Did you notice that regardless of what my exponent was, my answer stayed positive? Okay, my answer stayed positive. So that's going to be important in a minute because we're going to practice going back and forth for a second. But you need to realize a negative exponent does not change the sign over here. It changes the location in the fraction. Okay, it's a different way to write division is what it is. All right, so please note your base is positive, your answer is positive. Okay, so in logarithms, we only deal with positive bases. We only deal with positive bases. So what's your base up here? My base up here is a 2, because remember your base is whatever your exponent is attached to. So what I'm going to do, because I'm lazy, is, first of all, I'm going to write this as log, okay? L-O-G. Now I'm going to write what base it's in. And excuse me, I'm going to write that as a tiny, it's a subscript. So it's a tiny number. It's not up high like an exponent. It's dropped below, but it's a tiny number. So when you read this, it'll look something like this. It'll be a small number here. So you drop down to put that number in. Well, what's your base up here? Your base up here is a 2, so your base in log world is also a 2. Okay? The answer goes in the argument. So the argument is going to be the stuff in parentheses. So the argument is the stuff inside the parentheses. Parentheses. Okay. So in this case, I've got parentheses right here. Well, the answer up here is the argument down here. So what answer am I looking for? I am looking for 6.124. Okay, so the base is the base. The answer is the argument. So notice the A sound. The answer is the argument. And it equals, notice the E sound, it equals the exponent. It equals the exponent. So in this case, it's going to be an x. Okay, so what I've just done is I've taken this 2 to the x power equals 6.124. So 2 to some magical power is 6.124. And what I've done is I've taken something that I'm really going to have a very difficult time figuring out mathematically, and I've written it in a different format where I can actually figure it out rapidly. Okay? So instead of writing this in exponential world, you're going to write this as a logarithm. Okay, so again, I have a logarithm whose base is 2. The answer is the argument, and it equals the exponent. So now over here, x was untouchable because it's trapped up in the exponent. I can't reach it. Well, now all of a sudden it's reachable. Okay, so I'm not going to tell you what this is yet. We're just going to practice. So come back up here. If I have log base 2 of 16, okay, so the base is the base. The answer is the argument, okay? The answer in exponential world is the argument in logarithm world. And then that's going to equal your exponent. So that equals 4, okay? That equals 4. Okay, so now do you see that the answer to a logarithm is the exponent that makes this thing work? Okay, the answer to a logarithm is the exponent that makes this thing work. So now let's do this. I can have log base 2 of 1/2. Okay, so the base is the base. The answer is the argument. So the answer of 1/2 now becomes the argument in log world. And it equals the exponent that makes it work. So that's going to equal negative 1. Okay? So now, let's work backwards. Let's pretend for a second that I'm in log world, and I want to convert back into exponential world. So far, what we've done is we've started with exponentials, and we've moved into logarithms. Well, now we're going to go backwards. As long as your log is on the left, okay, all you have to do is go in a little backwards circle. So I'll have 2 raised to the 4th power equals 16. So it kind of makes a backwards swirl. Okay, it's a backwards circle. So 2 to the 4th. So 2 to the 4th power is 16. So that's 16. So this one is going to be 2 to the negative 1 power is 1/2. Okay, so I can convert back and forth rapidly. It just depends on what I need. If I actually have this portion done, well, then why would I go to log world? Because all I have to do is do 2 times 2 times 2 times 2, and that gives me 16. But if I don't know what the exponent is, that's going to be the benefit of going into log world. All right, so a couple other things. This is not the log times 2 times 16. Okay, so this is an operator. This is telling you to do something. Just like the negative up here was telling you to do something. Okay, just like me raising a number to a power is telling you to do something. this logarithm is telling you to do something. And what it's saying is, tell me what I raise the base of 2 to get an answer of 16. What power do I use to make 2 into a 16? I use a 4, because 2 to the 4th. Okay. What power do I raise 2 to get an answer of 1/2? Well, I raise it to the negative 1 power. So a couple more things, because this is your intro. The argument of a logarithm can never be negative. Can never be negative. Now, we have a way around that in upper level math. We just slap absolute values on there and it makes everything positive, so everything's great. However, go back to here. Remember, we're only dealing with positive bases. So regardless of the exponent I raise it to, it will yield a positive number. If the answer is the argument, the answer must be positive. The answer must be positive. So when I'm in log world, okay, I'll have the log of this thing. This has got to be positive. It must be positive. And then that's going to equal some number, okay? So another thing is that argument can never be zero. Okay, so the argument can never be negative. The argument can never be zero. So let's go back to our little list. The little list says, if my base is 2, what power are you going to raise it to get 0 for an answer? That exponent tells you how many times to use it as a factor. So even if I say, well, I'm not going to use it as a factor and I'll get 1 for an answer, it is impossible to change a base into a 0. It is impossible to change a base into a 0. So what does that mean in log world? In log world, that means your argument, or the stuff in parentheses, can never be 0. Because remember, that's the answer to an exponential. So this thing in the parentheses can never be negative. This thing in parentheses can never be 0. That is the law. That is untouchable. It will never change. Okay. Next thing. We have bases. You can have an infinite number of bases. Okay, I could have base 3. So I would have 3 to the 3rd is 27. I would have 3 squared is 9. I could have 3 to the 1st is 3. 3 to 0 is 1. And I could keep going. I could have a base of 5. I could have a base of 75 million. I could have a base of 27.2. Okay, there's an infinite number of bases. So just like when we don't write things, like if I have a square root, okay, it is implied that there's a little 2 sitting there. So if we use something the most often, we're not going to write it. So here's what I'm saying. I did not write a base right here. Okay, as soon as you acknowledge that, you need to understand that you are in base 10. Okay, so there's a little 10 down here that I'm too lazy to write. So how do you remember that? An L and an O, if I print, look suspiciously like a 10. So if your base is missing, okay, if your base is missing, it is implied to be 10. Now, what is this? Okay, I keep saying K, sorry. All right, so if I have, remember you can set anything equal to X. I don't have a variable over here, so look, it equals X. Now, I don't know what that is. So I'm going to change it back into exponential so you can see what's going on. Well, I need a base first. If my base isn't written, it's going to be a 10. Now, as soon as I got a log equal to something else, I can change it to exponential. So 10 raised to some power is going to be 100. Well, what do I do to a 10 to get to 100? I square it. I square it. So 10 to the x is the same thing as 10 squared. Well, your 10s match. So what does x have to be? X has to be 2. So come back up here. That's a 2. So log 100 or log base 10 of 100 is a really weird way to write a 2. It's a weird way to write a 2. And then I'm going to pick, because we've still got more to do for the intro. So we're going to have 2 intros on this video or on this section.